in the outskirts of town, laying in tall grass. It sways in a gentle breeze. A young woman basks in the sun's warmth. Would you please describe your character for me?
My character is Hina Hakutumu, and she's an 18-year-old. She has orange, like bright orange eyes with like a yellow ring in them, and her hair is pretty long, but the color is supposed to be reminiscent of like a sunset, so it goes from purple to pink to orange to yellow, and at the very end, it's a little white, I guess, but and she's pretty like 5'2". Yeah.
I'm assuming that you're kind of laying in this these rolling hills, like on your back, just like kind of
laying on my back. I got that medium golden skin because I'm always in the sun, just laying and watching the clouds pass by, wondering what else there is to come.
Does the sun's warmth feel a particular way for you? Does it bring you any peace or?
It's really calming. It's almost like being like in a sauna and just like. For some reason, it feels like it absorbs a little different. But.
You're a sunflower yourself. As you watch these clouds pass by, wondering what's to come, your memory jogs and you realize what should have already been as you promised Ren the blacksmith as her apprentice that you would have a sword finished by sunset. Which you haven't started.
I'm gonna say, I don't think I started it.
You do notice the sun is slowly coming down. You better be.
How far am I from the?
Not too far. You could realistically make it back even better with a good speed check to the village and whip something up because the consequences for
what's gonna happen if I don't do it?
The consequences for not performing this is a risk of the apprenticeship, scolding, and due to the fact that your dad works with the blacksmith as well, and your life at home would probably also be a lot more difficult.
I'm gonna take a deep breath and run over.
Speed check!
Okay.
Speed check!
12.
You know, you go sprinting through the village as you do arrive. You're 12, you know, you don't collapse. You don't run out of breath, you just keep a steady pace. You're not lightning, but you do make it to the village as people are looking at you like, that's the fastest I've seen her move ever.
Yeah. I was gonna say.
Like what the heck is going on? Someone almost drops their supplies that they're bringing.
Sorry.
As you go by, as you make it to the blacksmith, as you notice that Ren's not there, it's quiet, so you are not, you're avoiding the lecture for now.
Can I lock the door?
Yeah!
Yes!
You swing the door shut and you take the key that's next to it and you lock it!
I would put a little chair under too. Damn.
As you put the chair underneath, bracing the door,
okay,
the furnace, its glow and its warmth then touches your skin, and as you feel that heat, as now you are in your element here.
Look, time to make a sword. I know how to do that.
By God. Okay. You dash around the blacksmith. You collect your supplies and your material. You know this. Please make a raw d20. Actually, make me a discipline check.
Okay.
I'm gonna allow you to get that plus one in there.
Can I reroll?
You do have the lucky perk.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, you can reroll. You have 3 rerolls a day.
This is literally
the situation
you were talking about. Oh! That's not any better.
It's not any better? Oh, then it didn't count. It wasn't in the box.
Okay.
Patience.
Oh. 11!
Do you want to use your last lucky reroll?
Oh my God!
What?
Is it like long rest type thing? Or wait, no, it's a day.
It's a day.
The day's almost over.
I'm gonna roll again.
Go for it.
I'm gonna do it.
Come on.
Why do I have this?
Fortune favors the bold.
Oh my God.
Nice.
Okay, you found your dice.
Yeah, you gotta use that one instead.
Is it an 18?
Yeah.
And you added your plus one?
Yes.
Almost inhuman. dashing throughout the blacksmith. You are performing multiple tasks at one where you're like, you know, putting this in and you're like working on the hill over here. Somehow, as you're seeing through the crack of the wood, the sun slowly dripping down as it just touches the horizon as that orange glow begins, you somehow scrape together a sword. It is barely passable, but you've done it.
But I did it, yeah, that's what matters.
Woo! Look at that, huh? Pretty Mickey. Yeah.
What do you guys think?
Gorgeous.
Due to your extrasensory or your sensory ability, you were able to withstand the heat of the forge. Like, there were sparks and there were even just hot metal that was touching you, and but it didn't burn you. You're totally fine. As you hear the door try to open, and then it tries to open again.
I'm gonna go move the chair.
As you move the chair, please make a dodge roll for me, which is speed.
Oh,
two.
The door is kicked open by Ren as the door flies open as you grab the boom, as you all fall backwards, as the wood shatters go everywhere, as Ren's like, of course she's armed. Yeah, there's like an intruder in the village or whatever, the sword, the blade tip ends up just like...
Hi, Ren. Welcome back home. I can fix your door.
Oh, you're going to fix the door.
Okay.
Let me guess. No, let me just see. Do you have your sword ready for presentation?
Check it out.
She studies it. It takes about 3 seconds for her to realize that this is the worst sword almost ever created.
Ever created?
She draws it.
Good.
The blade is curved.
It's just, you know, it's got personality.
Personality.
It's not really about the way that it looks.
She chucks it to the other side of the corner as the blade... The blade snaps as it rolls over.
Oh my god.
You didn't start that until today, didn't you?
Well, you know, some philosophers say the greatest things happen in less than a day.
How did you come up with
that? I know, I'm like, did somebody actually say that?
That's not the philosophy that I've built this blacksmith with.
Right.
Do you know why you're my apprentice? Do you know why?
Like my dad.
She slightly blushes, but then she gets really angry as she starts scowling. Men have traveled all over to this village to ask to be my apprentice for me to teach them, and I've declined them all. They don't have a fraction of what you're capable of. Your laziness will be your downfall.
It's gonna be okay. Thank you for the apprenticeship.
It will be okay. Because you're gonna take over your father's job getting the coal from the village this next week. Hopefully carrying that coal for a day will teach you some humility and some work ethic. And don't worry, I'll keep your dad company while you're away. Oh. And she gives you almost a wink, a taunting wink.
Ew.
Well, can I have a rice ball on the way out? The trip tomorrow? Come on.
Yes.
Yay!
Begrudgingly, she says, yes.
Are you the one with like salmon inside? Okay, I'm just kidding.
She grabs a sword on the wall. She's getting ready to attack you, so it is definitely
time to
go.
I'll see you tomorrow.
She throws the blade as it digs into the wall right next to it. Sprinting through the forest, a feral 18-year-old girl.
Feral?
Runs as fast as the wind, as the breeze blows past, as you are in a foot race with a great white winter wolf beast as it's running up, as you're actually keeping pace with this monstrosity. Two legs against four.
12.
You are starting to lose the edge on Okami as you are starting to fall back, as she then swerves around a couple tree branches, which then trips you, and you stumble and collapse within a pile of bushes there, as meeting you as your eyes look up is her panting over you. I mean, she is almost like a dire wolf size, and she is standing over you as she's panting and almost taunting you for the loss there. You probably grab onto her fur to help yourself up. As you are on the edge of the forest, as you can kind of see a great green field stretching beyond. What do you do?
Smell? See if I can smell anything.
There is a aroma of flowers coming from the tree line beyond.
Brace you up!
Okay, shit. Make another speed check as you are now raising the field there.
Oh. Okay, wait.
You need a 15 to win.
Nice. 21.
You catch Okami off guard as you start sprinting, as she's tailing behind you, as you do just blow past the tree line into great field, as this beautiful lush grass stretches on as far as you guys can see, as there is a massive flower field of these beautiful radiant red camellia flowers. As you see the skyline, you see the mountain, this beautiful great mountain where your village rests at the base of, and it is deemed unscalable. As you think of the legend that Mr. Kazamura has told you of the ancient warriors that have lived up there, that have protected the village for many generations, lost to time. You can see from the positioning of the sun that you've been out a little bit too long. It's about to hit sunset and you have many activities left to do today.
Oh yes, all right, should we get back?
You've probably exhausted yourself at this point. If you're
Get on Okami and I've heard do
as a mount? Sure.
She's probably bigger than me, right?
Yes.
Like 5 feet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you can do it.
Okay. I'm
so good. There you go, trotting with Okami back to the village as you make it to just around the outskirts of it, as Okami then lowers her head as you slide off. It is deemed that Okami would probably eat some of the local children if allowed in the village. And some debate that you're also a risk as well. So,
you have rabies.
A risk as in eating children?
Yes. And so Okami then...
I started that rumor.
you pet Okami, farewell. You walk into Nakasa Village. People kind of give you weird looks, of course, because you are the weird feral outcast child. But you do make it through to Mr. Kazumura's house, your caretaker. You enter. You notice that it's definitely a little bit of a mess. But the first thing that you see when you enter is Mr. Kazumura's armor stand, as there is a shrine dedicated to his former life as a actual samurai. And there is his blade on a beautiful hilt, and his armor, you can see the details of it. You can see the dent marks of and the slash marks and the scrapes of many, many years of combat from when that was a part of his life. You see Mr. Kazumura, he is struggling to...
no enemies yet.
Being eaten by a demon.
Yeah.
His pupils faded from his blindness, from natural aging, as unfortunately it took his sight. So you've been his eyes for many years as he's trying to make himself a meal as he's kind of struggling, but he does hear you. And I thought you were gonna leave me alone on my birthday of all days.
Why would I? I would never do that to you.
You're lucky I can't tell what time of day it is, but I have a guess that it's a little bit later than usual.
I mean, better late than never, right? I'm here.
Very true. Good.
What do you want tonight?
We'll get to that after the chores are done. You get distracted easily.
Fine. I'm just getting hungry, but that's okay. I'll be quick.
Make a speed check for me. Demon Slayer, the TTRPG, House Chores Edition.
12.
Okay.
Another one.
Fucking 8.
You try your best, but ultimately, as you're trying to clean, you end up making several more messes. But it might not take as fast as you want, but as you are cleaning, he starts going on one of his tangents again, and he starts talking to you about his times as a samurai, where he would travel and how it was him and his two friends and how close they were and the bond that they shared and the just all the wildest adventures and places that they've seen, sword on their hip, open road ahead, and just a fighting life. And you could tell that he is reminiscent of it. He misses it.
Mm-hmm.
But it brings him a lot of joy to talk about, as especially on his birthday of old days.
Aww.
But you do finish the chores. He tests the dust. As he scrapes his finger along some of the counters. He laughs as you miss a couple spots, but he doesn't actually care.
Okay.
He just is trying to teach you discipline as you're kind of a wild child. What I would like for my birthday is I would like your help in putting on my armor with me. I want to wear it one last time. Age has already taken my sight, and one day it will take my legs. And I just one more time.
You don't think it's gonna be too heavy on you right now?
I can take it.
Okay, well, all right.
You don't forget.
I'll do whatever you want. It's your birthday.
Please make a strength check.
Oh gosh. So I add one to this because of the striking?
Yes.
Okay. Woo, 20. Oh, nice. It's all that tree climbing. Eight.
Effortlessly, he stands there. He just through muscle memory, he knows where to tie and where to put things. As you put the pauldrons on, you put the chest plate on, the armor skirt. As he is strong enough, he stands there. He shakes just a little bit as he kind of dips down from his knee almost gives out as it somewhat wobbles. But he stands there, and you can see through his eyes that a tear. Has fallen as he just stands there. You notice that his shoulders straighten and he just stands with such pride in that uniform and what his life was and what he accomplished. Thank you, Yuki.
Yeah. I mean, I know you miss those times, but it's not so bad here, right?
Let's do some celebrating. Enough alcohol will make anything great. Go get it.
Yes, sir.
As you then go to retrieve the alcohol, as I'm sure that you have a festive rest of your night. Hiking up a new trail of the mountain, exploring a new part of the paths today. Please describe your character for me, Maia.
Maia Raiden is an 18-year-old girl. She has dark brown eyes. She's a bit tan. Her hair is pretty long, but she likes to keep it in two high ponytails. Her hair is white with blue tips, and she is also pretty short, probably 5'2".
Short girl gang!
I know.
All three of you are super short, huh?
Yeah.
Please make a perception roll for me, please.
There we go.
12.
12.
Nice.
No, 12.
Very apparent to you, there is what seems to be a running stream of water. You hear it just kind of washing over the rocks and kind of going down. It's not a big stream, but it's a foot wide, but you've never seen this before on this path of the mountain. Mm. You just had to follow it?
Yes.
As you follow it, you walk it, the stream gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger as you start stepping on rocks, as then you make it to this dead end of this mountain as there is a rushing flow of water, creating a waterfall. The ripples are shimmering in the sunlight, and it's just like a beautiful, beautiful spot. Please make another perception roll for me, please.
14.
Yeah. With your sensory ability, with your hearing, you can hear your mother's voice booming from your estate. Your name, calling you home. Apparently this has happened before, where she's literally so far away and screaming, she knows you'll hear, and she is summoning you back home, which usually means it's time to go pretty quick. But before you do, is there anything that you do here at this waterfall? Is there anything that you take in?
Probably just dip my hand in.
Cool party!
Your character could use it to wash
off.
I know,
off. I was like, damn, that sounds really nice right now.
I know. Yeah. Did the mom sound like mad or just like yelling because she wants me to hear?
A little bit of both. You can never tell with your mom. She's a straight to business kind of woman.
Okay, I'll get home quick.
You are known as the jewel of the village. Mm. So as you enter through the main archways, everybody just stops and smiles at you, pretty much. Like, everybody from all ages. They're just they're greeting you, and there's warm smiles, as, you know, like, oh, we heard that, you know, you're getting called, you know, make your way over there.
Yeah, I'm sure everyone heard.
Everybody heard. You make it to the outskirts of your estate, and your mother is a world-renowned jeweler. and she uses these precious diamonds and gems that are only found within this mountain that the village is in the base of. And so she collects it and makes the jewelry, and then your father then goes out and trades, disappears for several months and comes back and starts telling you all these different kind of wonderful places you've been to.
But I know that he takes the jewelry.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And I'm assuming you've always wanted to be a part of these adventures with him, right?
I guess, yeah. It was just kind of like she's more inspired to see like outside the village because of the stories he tells.
Yeah. You enter through the outer wall. You guys have like a wall, and you then have a courtyard that has a bunch of beautiful, beautiful plants and bushes that grow different berries. And then you have, of course, your main estate, which is like three stories tall. This is definitely the largest complex within the village. And then there's the banner, your house sigil flowing. Other families of high class would know your family if they saw that sigil.
Okay.
You notice that something's tugging. You look down and at half your height, and you're already short. There is a little girl who's crying. And she's crying. Why don't you ever take me adventuring with you too? As you see one of your little sisters right there.
Oh, because you're too stinky.
More tears just start gushing out of her eyes, and then she runs away. You look down and you see one of your other little sisters who's looking up with you with such wide eyes, with such awe. Mm. Where were you? Where did you go? What did you find this time?
I found the most beautiful waterfall.
Will you take us one day?
No.
Please make a dodge.
Speed, right?
You gotta be tough on the...
Oh my god. Seven.
She kicks you in the shin, and then she leaves.
Ow.
And then, as you take two steps forward, you see a hand-sized ball flying at you with a ferocious speed. Oh. Make another dodge for me at speed.
Oh my god, 15?
How do you catch it?
What direction? It's coming straight from my
straight for your head.
Just...
Yeah. You the sound of the rubber as you just clench it. Anyway, as they're at the... At the foot of the stairhold is your third little sister, who's like, dang it! And she just like screams out. But she also is like, she has like a little bit of a smirk on her face because she's very amused by your lightning fast reflexes. So she's been trying to ambush you all
so
day. Oh. And so she goes, damn it! And she just runs inside.
Still too slow.
You walk inside to your disgruntled mother. Mm. Where did you run off this time?
Like went that way, and then that way, and then...
Do you not like us or something? Is there a reason why you spend all your time outside of the home?
Well, it's nice...
And not taking care of your little sister and responsibilities? Leaving it for me?
I just like to see the forest.
Do you understand that you might run into that feral, white-haired girl? She's dangerous.
You don't even know her, Mom.
I know of her.
Yeah, so you don't know her.
Chores? Get your sisters in order, and you must deal with those suitors that are outside nagging at our door calling for you. Marry them, decline them, send them packing, I don't care. Just get them away from my home.
Why do you even let them in?
It is at a time of age where you're allowed to meet suitors.
Well, I don't want to.
Well, you're going to, at least this time. I don't care if you say yes or no, find one you like. Just get rid of them.
What if I don't like any?
If I hear that one, there's one of them that's whining.
Oh my god.
And they have their whole parade out there. It just, and after
Maia,
that.
Please. Maia, please.
And then after
I
that.
I love you.
Your father has gotten ill.
What?
Yes, it's not too bad, he's fine. He's been through this before, but he's not able to make the shipment out, which means that you're going to step up and do it for us.
Yes.
That's a punishment.
Oh, boo.
That's much better. Get out of here, go.
Okay.
What's your next move?
Okay, I'll deal with the suitors.
Please make a dodge roll.
Oh, dodge again. My little sister. 17.
Damn it! From the top of the staircase on the second story, as it comes up, spiraling down. She's like, no! She runs away and grabs another one. But again, she likes it. She's impressed.
So
she's impressed every time. She's like, this is her life goal, is to to get you. You see four men in different body shapes, heights, whatever. You see all of them perk up and just start blushing. One of them immediately rushes up to you.
Oh.
The first man.
Okay. Oh God.
He is very short and scrawny as he drops to his knees. Please, Maia, marry me. Please, I'll do anything. I will cook, I will clean, I will take care of you. I will do anything you wish, anything you ask. I will kill for you. Just please marry me,
whoa.
Please, please.
Oh my.
I'm coming out a little strong, but that's yeah. Like,
you think?
But is that working?
No.
No, please. If you say no, I'll die.
Okay. Nope. I technically didn't say no.
He has a heart attack right in front of you and he dies right in front of your feet.
Oh.
He straight up and he collapses as he's dead. As
what the fuck?
Two villagers then come with a stretcher and put him on and take him away from your courtyard as
oh my.
He is deceased.
Where was he?
Damn.
Okay, so he's
go
dead.
Go pay my condolences.
Death count. One. One, yeah, we'll start having a tally.
The second man,
Some
tall, over 6 foot. He's the farmhand here, so he is shredded from all this work, all the plowing of the fields or whatever.
Uh-huh.
He stands there nonchalantly, kind of posing, big jawline, big Chad energy going on, as he then flexes. Need I say more?
No.
Your hand. No. I don't think you know. They said that if I came here and asked for your hand in marriage, that you said yes because I'm so charming.
Oh, whoever said that lied.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Going once.
Oh, okay.
Going twice.
Okay.
Your loss.
Right.
As he then walks out of your courtyard as well. The third man, he's in very aristocratic clothing.
Okay.
Very fancy. He seems out of town. He seems like he's actually traveled here. He even has like a little traveling cart of all this kind of stuff or whatnot. He sits there painting a flower with his tools. He puts it away as he sees you. He's like, it makes sense why you declined those other two. Because you made it to me. I am of noble birth. Your family will be proud of that. I am very wealthy and I'm a bit of a artist myself. Do you dabble in poetry?
Sometimes.
He then opens up a scroll on which he wrote. You are the cow manure to my soil. You enrich me. And from that soil, our love will grow strong. Like the roots of wheat.
Wow.
Or some other type of thing that people grow. Oh, I got one more.
Boring.
Our love that we will share will connect like water, which will create a larger source of water, which will then hydrate nature, like deer, and whatever other wildlife is around. And we will become like Mother Earth.
Have you ever like been outside?
I'm outside right now, as he's underneath a pop-up tent.
Yeah,
Hold up. Forget the marriage. What about the poetry did you not like? Because that is like, don't you under, I mean, it might not just understand. You might not have the level of artistry to understand the meaning of the, like the manure, like cow manure makes soil grow.
Mm-hmm. That's what it is.
That's like love.
That's what it is, because I'm a girl, so I obviously would not understand the intelligence a man has in his words.
I'm so glad you see it my way.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pack up and go now. Okay. I'm sure there's some other noble beauty back in the village.
Yeah, totally.
I wasted my day trip here.
Yeah.
As he then
tell them
takes,
the same
like,
exact
dude,
poems.
Can the little sister hit it?
The last suitor that stays there, he's been very quiet. He's the stable boy's son. He stands there with a horse. Hi.
Hey.
I was given this horse. They told me, if you marry me, I give you the horse. It seems like pretty good deal.
Yeah, I guess.
Is that a guess?
No, not really. Do you want to get married?
Sure.
But like, is that what you want?
Oh no, my dad thinks that if I marry into your family, that I'll like, you know, we'll be lifted into the wealthy and that we're gonna get a bunch of jewels and stuff. But I don't really care about any of that. I just want to get married and give you this horse.
Okay, you should give the horse and get married to someone that you genuinely like.
Did you choose for the horse?
She's just take the horse, I know. Sorry.
Yes.
It's a beautiful horse.
I take the horse, you take a sense of responsibility back.
Ooh.
Wait.
A sense of enlightenment back.
Please make a charm roll for me.
Ooh. Come on.
Okay. 17.
Ow!
Okay.
We go. Nice!
Wow. I can't wait to tell my family about this enlightenment that I've received, and I'm gonna follow my dreams and follow my heart and, exactly. and get married out of love and not out of the horse.
Yeah.
That's cute. I don't know how they'll take me giving away their prize horse. I think this was our best horse, but
that'll be okay.
As then he goes back to his family, and there you're stuck with a horse who's like looking at you kinda like disappointed. The horse was expecting a wedding.
Oh, man.
As you walk right back inside, please make another dodge roll for me.
Oh, jeez.
You know what's coming.
Aw, man. 5.
Gotcha! As the rubber that hits you right across the head and bounces off. It kind of stings. Uh-huh. And she's there like, oh, my, her life has been accomplished.
I
got you. And then she scurries away.
Oh, my God.
Morning activities begin in the village. It's very quiet, but you do hear, of course, carts moving around, people just, you know, getting ready for their day. As Yuki, you kind of stumble out of Mr. Kazamura's home for a bit, as you were allowed to partake in the drinking last night as well to celebrate.
Oh,
so, yes. Everything's like that. He looks he probably banged to the walls, and you guys had a very part two wild animals partying. Undoes something from his belt, and he pulls out his sword that he used as a samurai, and he gives it to you for protection, as he says, if you're gonna be a wild animal, you might as well have claws.
But what do I need this for?
To protect yourself.
From what?
You're going to the town, we're out of alcohol.
You want me to go into town?
I cannot. I'm a blind old man.
I just don't know if I should be interacting with people in town.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I didn't give you any money. You're gonna use that speed of yours, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I get what you mean. I get what you mean. Okay.
You're getting older now, which means that I'm going to abuse your speed and have you steal things from me.
Well. Oh. God, okay! All right, you can do this. You're fast, speed.
Your father gives you a warm hug if you want to say goodbye to him, as he gives you this big ass basket, this wicker basket. It's about as tall as you, being 5'2", or 5'2"-ish. Yeah, it's about as tall as you. And he gives you instructions on how to walk with it, to fill it, and he's like, oh, my back, or whatever. You think you could do this?
A smaller basket.
No, I've been doing this for years. This is what's put food on our table. Nope. As well as Ren's hospitality, of course.
Gross. nothing. I didn't say anything.
You know the route here. This is the map. There's pathways. I'm proud of you. This is gonna teach you character, you know?
Thanks. Is there any cool things to look at on the way there? Any spots I should stop at?
Do you like trees?
Yes.
There's a lot of trees.
Oh, just trees.
You see then Ren.
Did you pack a lunch?
Your father's so sweet. Yes, he did. He packed your favorite snacks, everything, just like in a go bag, and he just prepares you. You're gonna ask that? It's important to eat. Here's some money for when you get to town.
Okay.
If you want to buy anything that you like. I don't have much.
What do you want?
No, what
do you want?
A new bag.
Where am I supposed to buy that? The better back store?
Seems like you have your father's humor. You see Ren.
You got anything to help me before I go?
She comes up to you. Take this. If anybody attacks you, stab them. Shit. And okay. This is for when you lose the first one.
Yeah, I definitely will. Okay.
And this is for when you drop both of them.
Thank you.
But I have plenty of weapons. You are going to be more than fine.
Yeah. Okay, I'll be good.
All your sisters are still fast asleep. The one that's been crying has like a snot bubble that's going up and down and up and down. Okay. And you're passing all of their rooms. All of them are nice and tucked in. Mm-hmm. Your mother's obviously up and working. She presents you a almost like a treasure chest, as it has mm-hmm. all these jewels. Mm-hmm. She gives you instructions on where in the market to go and who to look for. So then she wheels out the cart, you know, to make it easier for you. At the entrance of the village, all three of you seem to converse.
Oh. Hi.
Aren't you the girl who eats kids?
I think so.
How do they taste? Yeah. Do you cook them or do you just eat them like that?
I like your sword. Thanks. It's not mine, but,
You stole it?
No.
Oh.
No.
Then where'd you get it?
It was given to me.
By your pet wolf?
Not my pet. Companion.
Oh.
I do not own her.
Okay. That's nice. Yeah.
Why do you have so many weapons? Are you here to?
No. This one is for when I lose this one, and then this one is for when I drop this one.
I just forget sometimes. I like to take a lot of breaks. Are you guys going to the town?
Oh yeah.
Hina, you also notice the cart, the wagon that. Maia is lugging around. If you want to be lazy. And not carry it.
Yeah, hey! It's like your cart.
Thanks, my mom gave it to me.
How much can it hold?
Probably a good amount.
I feel like there's a little bit of room right there on the side.
Oh yeah, there is a little bit of room.
All three of you make a resistance roll for me, please.
Ooh.
Nine.
Does that not count? Because it was a 10.
Yeah, it counts.
Six.
Nine.
All three of you have been walking and talking as you have had a very leisurely pace, and now you have missed your chance to make it there and back by nightfall. You'll have to make it up on the way back. But you guys make it far enough outside of the village where you guys start, you two particularly, start hearing rustling, almost beast-like footsteps. You start hearing a subtle growl. This winter wolf with this beautiful, beautiful fur coat, as it walks, it's growling at both of you. Whoa. As its teeth.
Oh, got me. It's okay. It's okay.
Make a charm roll for me, please. Oh, Yuki.
Friends, not food. Woo! 19.
Oh, got me then. Nods and then looks to you and then stops growling at you too. And then starts wagging its tail.
I'm a petter.
Yeah,
it leans in and allows
you. We run around the forest and fields together. She's taught me a lot.
Does she eat kids?
Only the bad ones. Buildings stretch for what seems like a mile as they're stacked on top of each other, as there's these cement roads and there's these paved roads, as the buildings are taller than you've ever seen, except for maybe your estate. All three of you are met with the sensation of activity and noise. It's both overwhelming, but also stimulating and exciting, as everyone seems like they're behind and that they're in a rush. And people are just like, it's not very polite because they got shit to do. So people are kind of nudging past you as you guys are entering, and they're like, get out of my way, I gotta sell this thing. Don't you understand, my livelihood is at stake.
No.
They're just freaking out. But also, you know, vendors are trying to, you know, sell stuff to you. And there's a lot of like, different kind of districts as well. There's luxurious district, there's market districts, there's all sorts of different stuff. And this is where you guys split up. Where do you guys begin? Let's start with you, Hina. Where do you go?
I'm gonna go to the store.
Which, like a general store?
Like where they have the baskets.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna go shopping.
there's somebody that is currently weaving a new basket right now.
What else is there around me?
People getting into arguments about prices. There's food. There's that's the kind of general area that you're in this kind of corner of the marketplace.
What kind of food
do you want there to be?
Is there like bread?
Yeah. There is a baker. Yes.
Yeah. I'm gonna go
in. Name Luigi. I'm just kidding. Some Italian just invaded over here.
It's a baker.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, no.
Bread.
What's an Italian doing here?
God. Wow.
It's now confirmed. There's an Italian here.
Yeah.
Do you buy bread from him? If you buy the bread, you might not have enough for the basket. So this is a choice. Bread or basket.
Maybe I could like beg for a discount.
Please make a charm roll to Luigi the baker.
Oh my god. Luigi, it's a me.
He's never met you before or seen you before in his life.
Oh, it's a seven.
I don't know you.
You are poor.
I've been getting from Italy here. I've never seen you before.
Can I smell one?
Permission to smell the bread, please.
You go up to one of the loaves and you just take a big inhale.
Could you imagine?
To the point where you weird him out so much. You can keep that one.
Really?
Yeah, mamma mia.
I'm gonna eat the bread and go to the basket store.
Perfect. So she's still weaving the thing she just finished. She's like, it's almost like version 2.0 of the basket that you have currently. Shoot to you, shoot to your basket, shoot to her basket, shoot to you, basket, basket. You gotta make a deal? Wait, why does she sound like that?
You wanna make a deal? Yeah, 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 make a deal.
You wanna buy a wicker basket?
I do. How much?
That amount. She points to the little coin pouch that you have. Man, you're poor.
What?
You're poor. Okay. You're not gonna make it far in this town.
And you're old. And wise. And beautiful.
Make another charm, for God's sake!
good backtracking there.
We'll see if it works.
17!
Jesus! 17. All right, you've corrected yourself. You have good manners.
Yeah, thank you. I learned them from my mom.
Did you know I also sell coal?
Oh!
As you see, there's a giant coal pile right next to her.
Wow. That's a really good business you got here.
I see the resemblance.
Oh, yes, my father. Mokutan.
I've heard a lot about you. Oh. Your father loves you very much.
Aw, yeah. I love him too.
Quit causing trouble for that nice man.
I'm not!
His back is going, and it should be you doing this. You're a strong young woman. You should be doing this for him.
Yeah.
I'm basically his therapist. He comes here and he vents to me.
You do therapy too?
Yes.
Oh.
I own this market.
The whole thing?
No, I meant like metaphorically.
Oh.
Therapy, yes. But your father gets free therapy.
He's
such
an Italian
nice man.
Guys.
The Italian man, Luigi, good bread.
Yeah. Do you want some? I still have a little bit left. I've been taking bites out of it though.
You can do two choices here. You can do the usual, which is about half actually. That's how much your father's been able to carry with his old age and whatnot. So that's
also a full basket. Then I don't have to come later.
Impressive, young lady. As she then fills your basket full of coal. Please make a strength check to see if you can lift this.
You know what they say? Laziness helps make like...
Yeah, I 18. What you
mean. Oh my god, you do it. Okay, holy shit, you've
you're
done
carrying
it.
Carrying groceries up. Yeah. You just carry them all at once so you don't have to do it again. You're
strong. So you take the new basket. It can withstand this. The other basket would not have, so good thinking.
Nice.
As you then put this on your back, yeah, your father, now he doesn't have to come back for a few weeks.
Nice.
You basically done double trips, so you've actually helped your father directly.
Aww.
Spend more time with Ren, so that's your fault. Maia, you approach the marketplace. You follow your mother's instructions to a T, as you then see a well-off middle-aged man with some graying hair in his goatee, and he humbly bows as you approach.
Wow.
Miss Raiden, it is an honor to meet you. My name is Oda. I'm sure your family's mentioned me.
Yeah, I'm sure they have too.
Really? Oh,
yeah.
Oh, sarcastic. How fares him? How is he doing?
Oh, okay. You know, he's holding up well. He's a strong man.
This is the first time that I've seen you make this delivery here.
I know, right? Isn't it so awesome?
You are.
My mom,
you?
Like, never lets me out. She gets so mad when I disappear for the day. And now she let me go out into town, which is just, like, so
well,
great.
Well, I hear that you have three sisters. I'm sure that there are a lot on your mother with her business.
Well, yeah, probably.
Now that you've grown into the business, welcome. What side do you think you'll take over? Do you think that you are going to be following in your mother's footsteps with the the design and the elegance and the craftsmanship? Or do you think that you'll take your father's spot and travel the world and sell these jewels?
Probably neither.
Did you know that him and I were in the Merchants Guild together?
I did not.
That's where we met. That's where he met your mother.
Oh, wow.
He hasn't told you about the stories?
Like, I'm not talk about them that
much. Important. Your father has been not only all around the country.
Oh, yeah.
Your mother's jewels have reached the shores of Russia, Great Britain, France, Italy.
Wow.
Did you know that the emperor's daughter, the princess, received one of your mother's jewels for her birthday?
No. Did she accept them?
Yes. It's a great... Do you not know who your family is? If you find yourself needing a friend, I am at your service. And so is the rest of the Merchants Guild. We love your father. Oh. It's a shame that he hasn't been able to travel as far now. Yeah. Ever since he met your mother and settled down, he's been only delivering it halfway to me here, and then I'm the one that now takes the jewels all over the world. Mm. We're not young anymore.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
You exchange the treasure chest, he puts it in his. Several armed guards then lock it up and escort into a carriage. Mm. About 7 armed guards.
Jesus Christ.
And exchange a heavier chest. All the wealth that you could imagine. I mean, you don't really, I guess, have a way of perceiving what the heck that even means because you've never had to worry about it or really experience, like, you don't go shopping. Mm-hmm. You walk around the village and go, I want that, I want that, I want that, I want that. Or like, you know, because your needs are met.
Yeah.
But this is a lot of money and it's very heavy. As the cart then moves, as he gives you another regal bow. He respects you and your family a lot. As you're searching for the town for bottles to snag, you accidentally come across the home in which your mother lived. It's been remodeled as a restaurant, but you still remember the shape of it as it kind of, the restaurant is only a mask to hide the pain and abuse that your mother went through. And you remember when she told you to run as fast as you can and never look back. It's a little rough.
It's a little jarring.
There are still some, it's repainted because of the scorch marks that you can rest in peace knowing that your mother took them down with her. Yeah. Let's see how you want to go about stealing this alcohol.
Yeah, did I find some finally?
You did.
Okay.
You did. So there's 2 different options.
Focus
there's
on the
A
mission.
And B. You see a group of Imperial soldiers.
Oh,
they're
God.
In their military uniforms. They're probably on duty protecting or guarding. They're off duty, they're leisurely. So of course there's a bottle of alcohol that they're sharing between themselves. And then there is next to the soldiers where there is a general store that is selling them. That is guarded by a lone old man and what seems to be a young, strong ox-like kind of apprentice.
Quietly be walking around.
Make a stealth check for me, please.
Okay.
This will determine a lot because you now are trying to look like you're being stealthy.
15.
You are stealthy.
I'm like waiting to see him not looking over here. Then I'm gonna grab 2 bottles and run.
Make a speed check, please.
Ah!
This will determine a lot.
Please. Don't. Oh my God.
No, please.
Okay.
Please.
17.
Oh!
Okay, nice.
Oh my God.
Okay, good.
Before they can react, the 2 store owners, you grab the 2 bottles and it's like a gust of wind just blows right by them as you are gone. As the 3 soldiers hear the sprinting and they kind of get alert as they kind of see you sprint around the corner, but they didn't see anything that happened. And so they're just like, they kind of get up the ready. I'm not going to pay enough of this. As they go back to sitting there. You escaped with 2 bottles of alcohol.
Yes!
That could have gone so much worse.
Woo!
They were gonna spot you stealing the alcohol, and then they were gonna shoot at you.
Oh my God. Imagine dead first.
Bro.
My heart. My blood pressure.
This is why I don't go into town.
All 3 of you do regroup. You see, of course, you're waiting at the front with your call, ready to go. Roll up with your cart, I guess, with all the money, and you just hear cha-ching, 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 cha-ching. And then you see...
They didn't put, like, any safety or anything? Like, the money's just out in the open?
Yep. Well, not in the open, it's in a chest. Same as you walked in.
Got him! I did it. All right, ready?
Yeah.
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 All right.
Okay.
Okay, you I guess run ahead a little bit until you run out of gas.
We gotta get back, right?
And you guys then begin your journey back home. A few hours later, you notice that night ambushes you as the sun dips, and you actually can't see the moon right now. There's such a thick layer of trees and foliage that you do not see the moon. So you're kind of just like wading through this kind of pitch black forest.
I put my charcoal basket in your car.
Well, I guess I'm pretty strong, right?
Yeah.
It's a decent cart.
Just carrying it.
Everyone make a perception check to see if you lose sight of the road. Okami rejoins you.
14. Oh, all right. That's 22.
You guys are fine. It doesn't even matter if you're what yours is, because these two are keeping you steady. They're like, what the Yuki? Come on, there's a road. Just like, tell the difference between the path and then the grass. Or
I
whatever.
See. Trees are more fun.
All three of you notice that all nature sounds around you have deafened. You mainly hear the fact that everything has gone for whatever radius that you're usually hearing. It's completely silent. As you guys come to a forest clearing, you come to that clearing in the forest where you can see the moon. As you gaze upon it, it is a full moon, but yet it looks sickly. There is a purple tint to the moon, a very bad omen, and there are almost like decaying veins that stretch along the moon's surface. You don't know if this is a hallucination, you don't know if this is real, but the moon above you is a horrifying sight. Overwhelming terror begins to start creeping and crawling under your skin. I need all of you to make a resistance roll.
Mm-hmm. My hair is standing up on my neck.
Ooh.
9.
Nash 20.
16.
Okay, you get your sword ready.
Yeah, is Okami still with us?
About Okami.
Oh.
You start hearing the sound of yelping as Okami next to you is starting to curl up and yelp in pain as you don't know what, it's picking up on something that is, it's a sound of pain as you're calming her. She comes and she tries to bite your arm as she's panicked. Please make a dodge roll.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, she's never done this before to me. Okay, 17.
You dodge that gash. If those teeth connected, you would have lost your arm.
Oh my!
She bolts as fast as she can into the forest, into the darkness, as you lose sight of her, as she runs. As you guys are all left in this silence with that moon, as you're kind of seeing those veins on the moon slowly creep and crawl along the surface, creating what seems to be a symbol of horror.
I'm gonna keep walking, but like be like a little slower to be more attentive to like my surroundings.
Okay, so you wanna proceed cautiously?
Yes.
Okay, do you guys stick together?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna like, so that when we're walking, it's like, her and then her with the cart and then me, like.
You eventually return into the outskirts of the village where Yuki, you smell fresh blood in a large amount. And Maia, you hear absolutely nothing except the creaking of wood that has been splintered. You guys are slowly approaching.
I'm getting chills right now.
You make it closer to the gate of the village as it is completely torn open. And there is no torchlight within the village. It is completely pitch black, only illuminated by this decrepit moon. What do you guys do?
Run straight to my house.
Same. Mr. Kazamura?
You all split up, okay.
Oh.
As you guys venture in, there are torn cloth. You see remnants of limbs, fingers, arms, legs, shredded flesh pasted onto the walls of some of these buildings as there are holes bashed through. Something absolutely horrible has happened here. There are Maia, as you make it through your estate, as you make it to the front door, you notice that blood has dripped on your head. The door is also caved in. Where do you search first?
The top where the blood's coming from.
You find that the blood is from your father's room, as the mattress in which he was sick on has been soaked in blood, as it is, it's so thick that it seeps through the wood flooring and began to drip down. Where do you search next?
Just run to the sister's room.
You search each of your sister's room. Make a perception check. Make another. You get three. Okay. One for each of them.
Wait, does that count? 14?
Sure, I'll take it.
Oh, wait, one for each of them? Fuck. Crit one.
You find two of their hairpins. There's no sign of your mother. Amongst the jewelry, you do find her necklace. A perfect, perfect gem.
Take it.
Yuki.
Yeah.
Where do you go?
Mr. Kazamura's house.
Okay. It looks untouched. The door's not bashed open. It is opened, but it's not in ruin.
Is there any, like, type of trail or track, like, around or anything like that? Okay.
Do you go inside?
Oh, yeah.
You walk inside. The armor stand is knocked over. The only remnants you find of Mr. Kazamura is in the middle of the floor on a rug. There is a small blood stain, and there is a short blade as well. As you are walking towards home, you will pass the blacksmith, which you see has been burnt to the ground in rubble. As you see shards of blades, different metals and weapons scattered throughout. It seems that whatever fighting might have happened, happened right here. There's no sign of Ran. As you return home, there's also no sign of your father. You can find his clothes and his journal, which he keeps, where he spends most of the pages doting on you and how much potential you have and how he's still proud of you and how you're gonna find yourself. But you can hear your father's voice as you read through this journal there. What do you guys do after you find the remnants of?
Could, like, probably go towards the center of town to just see, like, what else is happening.
Sure. Hina?
I'm gonna take my dad's journal, and I think I'm gonna be too shocked to run, so I'm gonna, like, slowly make my way back, but.
Wait, can I inspect the short sword? Is there anything specific about that at all, or, like?
Ceremonial.
Oh. I see.
Also, did I take my sister's pins? Can I take their pins too?
Yeah, the two. As you guys do kind of converge to the middle of town, you see a figure. You immediately sense his presence as he stands there. Yuki, you've been told by Mr. Kazamura so much about ancient warriors and about how they carry themselves and hold themselves, and you can immediately identify that this man is a warrior. Mm. He's bald and he has a grayed goatee. He stands around 6'1". He doesn't wear a uniform. He wears a traditional kimono, and he holds a particular blade. Hina, the blade carries an intense red hue. It's a color in which you've never seen before on a blade as well. Maia, you see on his face an expression of shame and rage. He's holding the sword with such an intense grip that his fingernails are digging into the other side of his hand as there's blood dripping from his hand as he's gripping it so tight as it's shaking. As you three all approach, he looks to you, makes brief eye contact, and looks down, and he sheathes his sword. He begins to walk past you, ignoring you, as you watch his footsteps as he walks seemingly to the base of the mountain.
I'm gonna tug on his arm. Oh. I'm gonna be angry.
Please make a speed check.
Three.
When you reach for his arm, he vanishes.
Oh!
You guys hear a as you see him as he's now further up, as you see him about to approach the trails in which you usually go up the mountain.
Kanashimi.